On this Thursday, March the 8th, we welcome you to this edition of our local news from the studios of WLAF Radio. You called, you told us on the street, you asked on Facebook, you text, you even come by the radio station, wanting to know what's up with 1450WLAF.com. It's been a long, frustrating 4 days here with our website being on the fritz. Although we're quite humbled by your questions of where's our website, just before lunchtime today, 1450WLAF.com was back up and running. And are we happy? In fact, we invite you to join us first thing in the morning on 1450WLAF.com for a very special story about a talented young man from La Follette. His name is Hank Hamblin. Hank's a seventh grader at La Follette Middle School, and he's going to be competing for the second year in a row at the Regional Spelling Bee in Knoxville. That's tomorrow morning on 1450WLAF.com and 1450WLAF Radio. We'll also feature Hank here on Channel 12 News tomorrow at 5:30. Since the sales tax increase failed, what's the next move for funding road repair? A property tax increase. Placing the sales tax referendum back on the November ballot? Those appear to be a couple of options. County Mayor William Baird says the bump in sales tax would have generated nearly $1 million annually. Campbell County has upwards of 700 miles of roads, and right now the budget only allows for paving about 12 miles of road a year. Baird hopes the referendum is back on the November ballot. County Commission goes back to the drawing board Monday night. La Follette City Council members met in session yesterday, Wednesday, March 7th, to vote several changes and improvements. Mentioned in the workshop on February 27th, the La Follette Police Department believes that the addition of a utility vehicle will improve patrol of the La Follette walking trail. This Wednesday, council members gave the department a green light to take bids for the vehicle. Vice Mayor Hatmaker suggested that an alternative to buying a vehicle for patrols was to place video cameras along the trail so that the trail could be monitored from the police station. While this could save the city a substantial amount of money, the concern was raised that the cameras might get stolen and no money or time would be saved in the long run. The new La Follette Library will be getting a plaque with the names of city officials and a plaque with the names of those on the library board. Also for the library, bids will be taken for paving and painting the parking lot. To the sound of loud applause, council members approved $64,000 for the creation of a new sports complex at the East La Follette Elementary School. Summer play may get a little wetter this year. The bid of $21,860 by Hallett Equipment was approved for the addition of several new features in the splash park. These will be mostly stand-up features such as dump and fill buckets. Look for the televised coverage of Wednesday night's City Council meeting on our web channel, 1450WLAF.com. School is out early Friday. If your youngster attends school at Campbell County Public Schools, you'll want to know that school is out at 11 a.m. tomorrow. Teachers, however, will have a full day. A Scott County man died in a late-night car accident. Tennessee Highway Patrol Trooper Warren Crumley tells WLAF that 49-year-old Brian Duncan of Winfield died just before midnight last night when the car he was driving hit a tree. It happened at Grand Baker Curve on a two-lane side street called Pleasant Grove Road in Scott County. Those of you familiar with the area know that's near the Winfield Library, just north of Oneida. The trooper says Duncan was not wearing a seat belt and that it would not have made a difference, as it's described that Duncan was headed eastbound on Pleasant Grove Road when he passed another car in a no-passing zone. Duncan then tried to get back in his lane to avoid an oncoming car. That's when Crumley says Duncan lost control of his 1996 Toyota Camry, sliding off the right side of the road, striking a tree. Duncan is suspected of driving under the influence. And we close this evening on a timely note. This is the weekend we set our clocks up forward 1 hour as we go to daylight saving time. Before you go to sleep Saturday night, just remember to set your clock ahead 1 hour. That way you'll be on time for church Sunday morning. Spring forward. Our local news continues in a moment. We'll have a look at the press release from the Campbell County Sheriff's Department. Time now to take a look at the Campbell County Sheriff's Department press release. We have six names on our press release for today. Michael Joseph Bayon, age 23, of Marietta, Georgia, for driving under the influence, no driver's license, violation of the open container law, violation of the implied consent law, possession of a Schedule II controlled substance, possession of drug paraphernalia, and displaying a suspended driver's license. 39-year-old Raymond Williams Gibbs of 415 Lindsay Mills Circle in Lake City for violation of probation, evading arrest, and resisting arrest. Pauline M. Kramer, 22, of 191 Commerce Street in Jellicoe for theft of property between $500 and $999. 28-year-old Jennifer Lynn McCullough of Jacksboro for driving while suspended. Justin McIntosh, 19, of 349 Ridner Lane in Jacksboro for theft of property between $500 and $999 on a warrant, a capious bench warrant, and violation of probation. And the last name on the list today is Sean Aaron Miller, age 32, of 907 East Prospect Street, La Follette. And this wraps up our local news today, but even though it does, there's still lots more to come your way on WLAF and Channel 12.
We sing happy birthday to you, and may all your dreams come true.
Happy, happy birthday.
Good evening, everybody. WLAF and Eastside Pizza and Deli bring you the Anniversary Club and Birthday Club here on this Thursday. Celebrating a birthday today, Everett Grove starts off our list. Tasha Shears also celebrating a birthday today. Got some twins here. Glenda Lowe and Brenda Rose both turned 51 today. Lonnie Isabel, 66. Vic King also celebrates a birthday, as well as Harold Brown. Harold turned 60 today. Magdalene Ivy and Sarah O'Rourke. Brenda Oakes turned 61. Michael Hatmaker, 32 years old. Jim Perry, 98 years young today. And David Bailey, 75 years old. So happy birthday to all of you. Hope you are having a good day here on this Thursday. Lonnie and Judy Isabel celebrate their 20th anniversary today. So congratulations to you. All of you are qualified for our upcoming drawing tomorrow morning. That's when Jim or Big Josh will be drawn two free dinners from Eastside Pizza and Deli, and all of you had to have a chance at winning that are on our birthday and anniversary list. If your birthday or anniversary are this week, got to hurry up and get it in here to me before early tomorrow morning. You can call me at 562-1450, 566-1450, or 562-3557. You can email it to WLAF at bellsouth.net, or if you want to fax it in, you can do it that way too, 562-5764. And that does it for our birthdays and anniversaries for this Thursday. We'll see you back here for the end of the week edition of Birthdays and Anniversaries tomorrow. Giving away a couple free dinners, so be sure to tune back in there. And stay tuned. Your news continues.